going to perform an enzyme assay for acid phosphatase, in which our substrate is PNPP. Then we need acetate buffer, MgCl2, and our enzyme. Our PNPP, that is the substrate, is light sensitive, so we have wrapped it in a black paper. We have to take our substrate, 1 ml tube. We have taken two tubes, one for blank and the other for test. We'll add substrate to the blank first, and the same way 1 ml of substrate to the test. Now we have to add acetate buffer, 1 ml to each. We add buffer so that any change in the pH during the reaction could be controlled. Now we have to add 0.1 ml of MgCl2 to both of the tubes. What Mg will do is, it provides the Mg ions is required by our enzymes as a cofactor. So you can observe also that we have added just 0.1 ml of the cofactor. Now we have to add the enzyme. We have to add 0.5 ml of enzyme to the test. Right now we will not add it to blank, so that the reaction could take place only in our test solution, not in the blank. So I am taking 0.5 ml of my enzyme to the test tube. Now we have added the enzyme to the test. Now we have to incubate these tubes at 37 degrees for 30 minutes. And after that, we have to add 11.4 ml of NaOH and enzyme to the blank, because we want the tubes to have equal volume of the solutions. Now the incubation is over. Now we have to add NaOH, 0.1 and normal NaOH, 11.4 ml to both the tubes. The reaction which has taken place in our tubes are, the substrate, that is PNPP, in the presence of our enzyme got converted to PNP, para-nitrophenol. Now this para-nitrophenol gives us a yellowish color when it is exposed to basic alkaline condition. So now we are adding 11.4 ml of NaOH, which will provide the basic condition it requires for the color formation. 10 ml I have taken with the 10 ml pipette. Now I will take 1.4 ml. Our blank is having 11.4 ml of NaOH required. Now in the test, I will add now NaOH. Now we can see, after adding NaOH, as I have said, the basic condition had given the color, the PNP, the color of yellowish color. We can see the blank is colorless and the test is having yellowish color, because it has the enzyme which converted our substrate, that is PNPP, to PNP. Now we have to make the volume of both the tubes equal. As we have added enzyme 0.5 ml to the test, now we are going to add 0.5 ml of enzyme to the blank, so that the volume should be the same. NaOH actually does dual purpose. It provides basic condition for the color formation, as well as it is also an inhibitor for the reaction. So what it does is, now when we are adding the enzyme to the tubes, there is not going to be any reaction in the tube. So no yellow color formation will be there in the blank, and the test will have yellowish color. Now we can check the OD of these tubes at 410 nanometer, and as we have prepared the standard graph, we can calculate the concentration of our product, that is PNP, formed in our tube. And by the concentration we get in the test, our test solution, we can calculate the enzyme activity for our enzyme. The practical by which we are going to prepare the standard graph, we have to use PNP. It is para-nitrophenol, which is a light sensitive reagent, so we have kept it wrapped within a black paper. Then we will use distilled water, acetate buffer, and 0.1 normal NaOH solution. To take our reagent, for the first tube we are going to take 0.2 ml of PNP. Okay, so I'll take the whole. We have to take 1 ml. Now we are done with the liquor. Now we add distilled water to make the volume of each tube to 1 ml. Now we have to add acetate buffer, 0.5 ml to acetate buffer to all the tubes. I'm here with a pipette of 5 ml. So I can take 2.5 ml 2 times, so filling up. And the same way we have to add acetate buffer 2.5 ml to all the tubes. Now we add 9.5 ml of 0.1 normal NaOH. Happening in the reaction is that PNP, that is para-nitrophenol, is going to give us yellowish color when it is in basic condition. And by adding 9.5 ml of and the NaOH, we are providing the basic medium, and thus our PNP, that is the reagent added to the tubes, will give us yellowish color according to the aliquot we have taken. As I am adding the NaOH, the color formation is taking place gradually, and the color intensity in each tube according to our aliquot will differ, and that color we are going to study. The intensity of the color will give us the concentration. In this case, we are knowing the concentration. We have to just calculate the optical density of each color, so that when we do the enzyme-substrate reaction, we can prefer this graph. Our product PNP is going to give us the color. Now we can see the color of all the tubes. As we have increased the concentration of the PNP, that is our reagent, the intensity of the color has been increased. And now we just check the OD of all these tubes at 410 nanometers.